Boolean is so good, why is there no Boolean 2? Many are asking this. At last, I have created a worthy successor to the classic one-bit variable. Let me start with what problems I wanted to solve. I don't know about the rest of you, but lots of bugs in my games are caused by a variable having the wrong value. When you set a Boolean to true, you have to remember to set it to false again later. Now this is no problem if you can write perfect code and consider every edge case, but human beings are not perfect. Sometimes the script that set it to true is disabled before it can reset it to false. Sometimes an exception is thrown. Sometimes multiple scripts are trying to set the same Boolean, creating conflicts. What if the Boolean was a little bit smarter? What if it was resistant to these kinds of bugs and oversights? Introducing the BoolTimer. It's similar to a regular Boolean, except it automatically sets itself to false again when it should. Let's say you want to set a BoolTimer to true for 1 second. All you need to do is say BoolTimer.set1. Let's say you want to keep a BoolTimer true while something is happening, and then reset it after. You can simply set it for a short amount of time every frame that the thing is happening, and it will automatically reset once this is no longer being called every frame. My favorite quality is that they can be set for many different places at once without conflicts, which is great for gameplay systems that may be affected by multiple other systems. By default, the BoolTimer will remain true until it reaches the end of the longest set call it has received, but in a pinch you can also override it to reset sooner. You can also manually reset it, of course. BoolTimers have been invaluable for programming many gameplay features in my games. Some examples. Invulnerability. It is very important that invulnerability does not accidentally get left on, so BoolTimers are great for this. Attack states. When an enemy attacks, it needs to know to not attack again until the first attack is finished. Easy as setting the BoolTimer for the duration of the attack, or setting it repeatedly until the attack is finished if it has a dynamic duration. Any sort of a delay, really. It's a pain to keep track of a bunch of timer floats and update them or check them every frame. BoolTimers are a perfect structure for more readable code. Alright, let's look at how to implement them. I'm using C#, but it should be no problem to create one in any language. We had a reset time float, which keeps track of when the BoolTimer will return to its false state. Its value will simply be whether the current time is less than the reset time. Now we add a set function, which will set the reset time to some time in the future. If the reset time is already further in the future, we don't want to overwrite it, so we use a maximum check. A variation of the set function allows us to overwrite it intentionally. A reset function sets the reset time to the past, thereby setting the value to false. Finally, an implicit operator allows us to read the value of the BoolTimer as if it was a regular Boolean. And that's all there is to it. Your BoolTimer is ready to roll. It's simple, foolproof, clean, and versatile. Truly, in my opinion, a worthy successor to the Bool.